Every year in the United States, 6.6 million injections of Botox are administered for cosmetic purposes by surgeons certified by the American Society of Plastic Surgeons. In addition to cosmetic use, physicians are increasingly using Botox for medical conditions such as migraines, overactive bladders, and even for individuals that have excessive sweating issues. However, Botox has not come without a risk for potential side effects. One of the most common side effects due to poor injection technique is the paralysis of non-targeted muscle groups. This can lead to conditions including inappropriate facial expressions and headaches in patients. Botox operates by making its way into neuronal cells and disrupting the communication lines with other cells such as skeletal muscle. So with that information in mind, you may be wondering, how does Botox get into neuronal cells? Once inside these cells, what does Botox do to inhibit the signaling ability of neurons? To answer these questions, we need to understand the bulk transport of molecules across biological membranes. So, let's first explore how Botox gets into cells by endocytosis. Endocytosis is an energy-requiring process that brings molecules across selectively permeable biological membranes in bulk. This dynamic process involves the invagination of a localized region of membrane on the cytoplasmic side. This invaginated membrane eventually pinches off to form a membrane-bound vesicle that moves molecules from the extracellular space into the cell. Endocytosis can be further divided into three specific types. The first type is termed phagocytosis, or cellular eating, which is used to take up large molecules and in some cases whole cells. For example, unicellular eukaryotes such as paramecia and amoebas engulf food particles using phagocytosis. A second example would be macrophages, a type of leukocyte that is instrumental for the innate immune system in multicellular organisms. These cells can engulf apoptotic cells or a whole bacterium. The second type of endocytosis is pinocytosis, or cellular drinking, which brings fluids and dissolved solutes into the cell. All cells carry out this random sampling of extracellular fluid to bring in nutrients and other molecules in solution. The third type of endocytosis is termed receptor-mediated endocytosis, which results from specific molecules binding to receptors integrated within the plasma membrane. A high concentration of bound molecules induces vesicle formation and movement into the cytoplasm. Thus, receptor-mediated endocytosis is highly selective and concentrates cargo that will be taken up into the cell. An example of receptor-mediated endocytosis would be the uptake of circulating lipids in the bloodstream, such as when cholesterol is taken up in the form of low-density lipoproteins after they bind to their cognate receptors. Outside the cytoplasm, the functional subunit of Botox is able to escape from the membrane-bound vesicle and gain access to the cytosol, where it can effectively inhibit exocytosis. Let's now take a look at how exocytosis works. Exocytosis is a mode of bulk transport that moves molecules across biological membranes from the cytoplasm to the extracellular space via vesicles. This energy-requiring mechanism is often used for the secretion of molecules such as proteins. Cytoskeletal components bring membrane-bound vesicles into close proximity to the plasma membrane. After water molecules are displaced, the phospholipid bilayer of the vesicle fuses with the phospholipid bilayer of the membrane. This allows the contents of the vesicle to be released into the extracellular space. An example of exocytosis is the secretion of polypeptide hormones, such as insulin, into the bloodstream from beta cells of the pancreas. Another example of exocytosis would be the secretion of digestive enzymes, such as pepsigen, which is post-translationally processed into pepsin by epithelial cells that line the stomach lumen. Botox uses and influences bulk transport mechanisms in neuronal cells. This includes using endocytosis to gain access to the cytoplasm of a cell. While inside the cell, Botox inhibits exocytosis of chemical signals that are needed to stimulate other cells such as muscle. Botox can be used for cosmetic and medical issues, including knee pain in athletes and active individuals, by inducing partial paralysis of muscle.